Hi, my name is Jose Barreto, and I'm a product manager with the SharePoint team. In this demonstration, I'm going to share how to pull data from SharePoint using the Microsoft Graph Data Connect. So we are going to start here at the Admin Center for Microsoft 365, and we are going to find, under settings, the org settings, and in the list of org settings, find the graph Microsoft Graph Data Connect. This is where you will enable the MGDC and provide an approvers group. That's the group that's going to approve the data requests. Make sure to also enable the SharePoint Online and OneDrive checkbox. It's here also that you'll find the Privileged Access Management portal, which is the place where you would approve these data requests that I mentioned. So here, for instance, the request that came in earlier, this has already been approved. All right, we're set up in the Office site. Now we're going to go to the Azure portal and use it to manage a few things. So first thing, I want to create an application registration. So here in the Active Directory, the Azure Active Directory, I go to App Registrations, and you see that I have an app already registered. So this app is the identity I'll use to run the requests to Microsoft Graph Data Connect. In this case here, the credentials are being defined as a secret. You also can use a certificate. Now back to the home here, another thing I need to do is set up a storage account. So here I have a few storage accounts. This one I'm using to store the data coming from the Microsoft Graph Data Connect. So you need a regular account and for storage, but you do need to grant it the correct permissions. So if I go to access control here, go to role assignments, and I see that I have here with a storage blob data contributor, a permission granted to the MGDC app that we defined earlier. This is important so that the app can write to the storage. Also, in the containers, you want to create a container for your data coming from MGDC, and you probably also want a folder where you will put the files. So these are the files from a previous run already landed here in the MGDC files container under the sites folder. All right. So now that we have taken care of all the prerequisites in the Microsoft 365 and Azure, we are going to move over to pull data using Azure Synapse Analytics. I'm going to click here. I have several instances. I'll use one of them. And when I get into my Synapse workspace, I basically just click on the button to open the Synapse Studio. So in here, you will find this integrate icon here where we have all our pipeline. So in my case, I have one pipeline. This pipeline has one action, which is a copy data action. You'll see that it has a source, which is Microsoft 365, the MGDC. It has a sync, which is our Azure storage account. And you'll see here in the properties, the source as the data set, in this case, the sites data set for SharePoint in MGDC, and the destination as that container and folder that we mentioned before. So this is an existing one that I can just go here and trigger. I can trigger it immediately, or I can schedule it to run regularly, like daily. But if you don't have this one, you want to create one, the easiest way is to come here to this plus add new resource, and then say, I want to use the copy data tool. So this one will create a task that brings data into your Azure storage, and we're going to use the MGDC as the source. So we're going to use the built-in copy task and run once. And then here as the source type, we are going to search for 365. So we're going to use Microsoft 365. We can use one of the existing data sources or create a new one. You have to use that past the credentials and all that. After that, it's going to test the connection and find a list of data sets that we could use. So I'm going to go all the way here and say, I want to use the sites data set. Click on next. I also need to select the date that I want to use. So I'm going to say I want to filter for the snapshot. And let's say we are going to use the 25th as my date. Good. And we're going to click next. So now that we have our source defined, I'm going to go and select the destination. So use ADLS Gen 2. And for my connection, again, I can use an existing one or I can create a new one and pass the credentials. So in this case, I'm going to select the location. So as you remember, we had the MGDC files container in this account, and then it has a sites folder here. I'm going to select it. So it puts it in place. I'm going to say next. And the last thing I need to do is to give this a name. Let's call this sites2. save. And if I go next year, it is actually validating and deploying this pipeline. And they have been created. All you need to do now is to finish here. So now I have my two pipelines. And the next thing you probably want to do is to monitor a pipeline. So I have a previously run pipeline here that we can take a look. So if you look here, we have the sites pipeline. I can look at the details of everything that happened inside. So obviously it has the copy task inside and I can monitor to see what happened. So you can see here that it pulled data from M365, stored in Azure, and took 11 minutes to do that. All right, so with this in place, you have your pipelines running and you have the ability to go back here in Azure, in the Azure portal, look at your storage accounts, and inside the right container, you're going to find the MGDC files container and the files that we talked about. So these files are basically JSON files containing the data that you requested, and you can simply download them from here if you want to take a look at them. So I have one downloaded that you can see here, has a list of sites and has all the data that we request, multiple sets of data. And you can certainly download and use it locally, but you can also access directly from the storage account. So let's take a look at how you would use this from Power BI. So here is a Power BI dashboard using the data from the MGDC about sites, about SharePoint sites. So for instance, here I have a chart of our templates, different types of template that I use, and what is the total size and bytes that each one occupies. This one, for instance, is how many sites by owner. So you can see this as well. And here is a summary of number of sites that were created on a particular month. So how do you make this happen? So you basically drop a visualization here and you pull the data from the Azure storage account and it becomes available to you here. You can basically drag and drop from the data to the visualization. So if you want to take a look at how this query in Power BI is defined, you just go to add a query. And you can see here that the data is being pulled. The source of the data, as you can see, is the Azure Data Lake storage. And then you do some filtering and renaming of columns and expanding, and then you get the data in a format that you can put in your dashboard. So in summary, you saw how we can pull data using the Microsoft Graph Data Connect from SharePoint. In this case, we showed you how to pull the sites data set, and then you can bring that over to your Power BI and create dashboards out of it. Thank you so much for watching.